Good morning, students, and welcome back to Digital Classroom. Today I'm going to take the topic Modal Auxiliaries for Standard 10th subject English Grammar. Students, modals are also called as modal verbs. They are also called as modal auxiliaries. They are also called as special verbs or helping verbs, which behaves irregularly in English. They are very different from normal verbs. Normal verbs means the main verbs. Can you write down in your book some of the main verbs? For example, any five. I hope you have wrote, because verbs have played a very vital role in our English grammar. Isn't it, student? Yes. So I hope you have wrote. For example, work, play, read, visit, swim, sing, these all are your main verbs. What are these modal auxiliaries? These modal auxiliaries gives us additional information about the function of the main verb. They have great variety of communicative functions, and these functions we are going to learn today. Because the exact question asked in your exam is that pick out the verb auxiliary, that is pick out the modal auxiliary in each sentence and state what does it denote or what is its function. So this is the question asked in your exam for 2 marks. What are the characteristics of modal verbs or modal auxiliaries? They never change their form. Means what? They don't get any of the extension like s, ed, ing, es. So they don't change their form. They are used to indicate modality and allow speaker to express certainty, possibility, willingness, obligation, necessity, ability, criticism, everything that is seen in these modal auxiliaries. List of modal auxiliaries which we are going to learn today are can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, must, ought. This all we are going to learn today along with their functions. Now here you can see. First is must. Now what does it express? It expresses strong obligation and logical conclusion or certainty. Now how does you will understand? So by the example, just see the example, read the example. First one, you must stop when the traffic lights turn red. Obligation means your duty. You must stop. You must obey your parents. Again, this is your strong obligation. So what you are going to do in this sentence, you're going to underline must and you will write it is an obligation. Similarly, logical conclusion and certainty. We must be very tired. He must be very tired. He has been working all day long. Next is must not, that is prohibition. You must not smoke in the hospital. Next, can expresses ability, permission, possibility. Now what does ability example gives us? I can swim. Permission, can I use your phone please? Possibility, smoking can cause cancer. So from the examples you can understand what are the functions of can. Could, ability in the past, polite permission and possibility. See the example. Excuse me, could I just say something? It is the permission. When I was younger, I could run fast. It was the ability. And it could rain tomorrow. Possibility. Next is may. expresses permission, possibility or probability. So the example for it is, may I use your phone please? It may rain tomorrow. Might, polite permission, possibility or probability. The example for permission is, might I suggest an idea? I might go on holiday to Australia next year. Possibility. Need not, absence of obligation or lack of necessity. I need not buy tomatoes. There are plenty of tomatoes in the fridge. Next is should or ought to. 50% obligation, advice and logical conclusion. I should, ought to see a doctor, or I have a terrible headache. You should or ought to revise your lessons. He should or he ought to be very tired. He's been working all day long. So, here you can understand these are some of the modal auxiliaries. They're expressing means they are the functions and the examples. Let us go pick out the modal auxiliaries in each sentence and state what does it denote. The first one. She couldn't perform well in opera. Yes, students. Now, what you are supposed to do? You are supposed to write down in your grammar book. First, pick out the modal auxiliary. How you will pick out? You will write down below, couldn't, yes, and what does it tells you, which function does it tell you? She couldn't perform well in the opera. Now, one thing you do, students, what you are going to do, you are going to write down the modal auxiliaries. Pause your video, go behind in your notebook, write down all the auxiliaries what I have given you and the functions which I have given. Once you write down those, it will be easier for you to find out which sentence it is. She couldn't perform well in opera. So, couldn't means ability. This is lack of ability. She couldn't perform well in the opera. So, how you will write down the answer? You will write down couldn't dash lack of ability. Next is, Amit might need his father's permission to accompany his friends for the overnight cab. So, what is the modal auxiliary here? Might. Very good. And what does it, which function does it tell? Amit might need his father's permission to accompany his friends for the overnight camp. So it is a possibility. Next is, Rahul can walk along the hilly road without falling. So what is modal auxiliary in this sentence? Which one is the modal auxiliary? Can. And what does it indicate? Ability. Very good. May I come to see the new pet? So, may I come in? Might be a permission. May I come to see the new pet? Asking permission. So, what is the modal auxiliary over here? May dash permission or request also can be correct. Sure? I would be very happy if mom does not leave her job. I would be very happy. So what is the modal auxiliary here would, and the function is certainty, certainly, yes or no, shaky. Next is, you ought to finish your work in time, means you must finish your work in time, or you should. So this becomes your obligation. I could bake a cake for him. I could. So could is your modal auxiliary. I could bake a cake for him. So answer is ability. Very good. I hope students you have taken down all these 7 sentences and the functions. Let's go to the next. Her mother would be going to the market today. Would be. So, would is the modal auxiliary and certainty. Very good. We all ought to take care of our parents when they are old. We all ought to. We must. We should. There is no other option. So, ought is your modal auxiliary and what is the function? Yes, it is a obligation. Very good. Sumit wouldn't take no for an answer. Never like to take no for an answer. Any of the question if he asks and if you say no, he doesn't like. That is the meaning. Sumit wouldn't take no for an answer. So, it is certainty. Yes. Next is, Animesh told Reena that he would surely teach her how to fly a kite. Would. Again, certainty. Very good. Tulip, you must promise to do your best. You must. Necessity. I might have to attend the housewarming party over the weekend. Might. I might have to. So, possibility. You all must ensure that all the guests are well looked after. You all must ensure means you must or you should. So, it is the necessity. Wearing red could bring her ill fortune this week. Wearing red could bring her ill fortune this week. Kuch alag hone wala hai ya to kuch galat ho. So this is just a prediction. Yes or no? So wearing red could. Could is your modal auxiliary. It is the possibility. Very good. I hope students you all are writing down the sentences. If you haven't, please go back all these sentences I want in your grammar book. Now this you are supposed to do. Can I open the window, please? I hope you have underlined the modal auxiliary and wrote the answer function for it. Okay, the answer for it is, can I open the window please? So modal auxiliary is can, answer is permission. Very good. I can cook, but I can't drive. Write down the sentence. Okay, so modal auxiliary is can, and what is the answer? Function for it is I can cook. Ability, very good. I must call my grandmother today, it's her birthday. So, what is the modal auxiliary? Must. And what is the function? I must call my grandmother. Duty. When it is duty, it is always obligation. I must be there before 8 o'clock. I must be there. So must is your modal auxiliary. You must be there. So it is always yes. Think. Yes, students, you need to do it very correctly. 2 marks nahi jaane chahiye apne. So it is a compulsion. Would or could. Could you lend me a few dollars? Can you give me few dollars? Can any answer? It can be. So, underline the modal auxiliary. It's would or could. So, what will be the function? Yes, it's a request. I hope you all are solving it. You should not have done this to me. You should not have done this to me. So underline the modal auxiliary should not have done this to me. So, it is the criticism. I hope you all are solving, students. She must be driving. She must be driving. So, underline must. Yes, very good. It's modal auxiliary. And what is its function? Possibility. She must be driving now. It might rain in the evening. Might rain. It might rain in the evening. So it is, might is again your modal auxiliary. And what is your function? It is possibility. Very good.
Need I wait any longer? Need I wait any longer? So it is. Underline the modal auxiliary. Need. Very good. What is the function? Necessity. Very good. So write down. You ought to follow traffic rules. Your duty. So you ought to follow traffic rules. So it is, ought is your modal auxiliary. And what is the function? Very good. Obligation. Students, I hope you have understood all the exercises which we have done today. In coming lessons or coming sessions, we will be doing more examples of the grammar topics which we have covered before, the revision sort of, because all these topics are very important. The rules are very important. You need to be revising them every now and then whenever you get time, because unless and until you are thorough with your rules and regulations of grammar, you cannot solve the exercise. And this grammar is for 30 marks, which is very important for scoring. If you are perfectly right, then you get full marks. Otherwise, you lose all your marks. There is no half mark. We can say there is no possibility of getting half mark. Either you get complete full marks or you get zero. So rules are very important. Syntaxes are very important. Whenever I tell you that these things are very important, you need to understand them. If you don't understand, students, what you were supposed to do, you again and again watch the video, still you don't understand, you can WhatsApp me on our school group your queries, and your queries will be solved immediately. So I hope you all will complete these three exercises which I have given you today along with the answers, and understand it and then do it. They are very easy, and the same type of questions are asked in your exam. So study hard, take care of yourself, and let's meet in next session. Thank you. Bye.